Good morning, everyone, and welcome to the press conference of the Coalition Group from Harlem. We are here this morning to talk about what is happening in Harlem with respect to displacement and gentrification. And on that note, we are here to announce a major campaign in Harlem that will begin on Saturday, June 21st, where we will hold a march and rally in Harlem. This march and rally is against displacement. We are going to start this historic march at Marcus Garvey Park. That's at 124th and 5th Avenue. And from there, we will gather at 10 a.m. We will leave at 11 a.m. and march throughout Harlem, going across 125th Street up to Broadway, over to Broadway, and from Broadway up to 145th, over to Frederick Douglass Boulevard, and we will go southbound to 115th and Morningside Avenue. We are going to march throughout the community to highlight the displacement that is taking place in Harlem, and also we are going to discuss what we perceived, and others would agree with us, the amazing transformation on 125th Street from river to river that will lead to the displacement of thousands of Harlem residents as well as hundreds of local businesses. It has already started with the approved plan of the 125th Street river to river proposal that was approved by the New York City Council in March of 2008. And in this river to river, 125th Street river to river proposal, it is projected that 3,845 units of housing, mostly luxury housing, will be built and developed within this 24 block corridor from 2nd Avenue to Broadway, from 124th to 126th. This development, these projected developments, again, are mostly for luxury housing. It will displace and add to the gentrification pressure against hundreds and thousands of low-income Harlem residents and tenants. The median income in Harlem is less than $25,000. So of these 3,845 units of luxury housing, only 200 of those units will be for families and individuals earning below $30,000. And that is just the tip of the iceberg, because in East Harlem, with the East 125th Street Development Project, 1,100 units are projected to be developed within that five-acre site from 2nd Avenue to 3rd Avenue, from 127th to 125th. Also, it was recently discovered in East Harlem, the Negro Burial Ground. Not a single politician in Central Harlem, West Harlem, and most of all East Harlem have uttered a word about the preservation of these of this sacred, consecrated ground in which hundreds of people of African descent, slaves, who were part of the settlement in Harlem in the 1600s, are buried, and that is east of 2nd Avenue. We are here with a number of demands, including the recognition of the African burial ground. We want to also talk about the abuse of eminent domain, as we have seen it in West Harlem with Columbia University, and as we are witnessing the abuse of eminent domain in East Harlem in the East 125th Street development site. We have with our press conference will be very brief this morning, but we do want you to hear some voices of members of our coalition that we have pulled together, and the importance of this coalition with respect to Black and Latino unity is very, very important and something that we cannot stress enough, because without that unity, without Black and Latino unity, in the gentrification and the development of the greater community of Harlem, we all will be on the losing end of housing and being able to preserve our neighborhoods, our homes, as well as our communities. Our first speaker this morning is going to be Danny Vila. He is an activist and also a journalist with the Working People's Voice. I give you Danny Vila.
Básicamente reforzaría lo que ha dicho la compañera Nelly Bailey. What we're going to have on Saturday is going to be a mass protest of people who are just sick and tired of being kicked out, being evicted from their neighborhood. Black, Latino, white working class people are going to come together. Small business people also from 125th, from Broadway, from all of Harlem, East Harlem, El Barrio, Washington Heights will congregate, will lance a shout of protest saying that this is their community. This is not the community of the rich developers. This is not the community of the big corporations. This is their community. They've been there for many decades and generations, and they insist on remaining there and raising their children there. They insist that low-income housing be preserved, that there will be subsidies for people that live in the projects, in public housing, and they also demand an equitable, decent, and free education also for their children. So we will be marching on Saturday at 11 a.m., and we hope that everybody will be present and support us.
We have with us a former member of Community Board 10 in Central Harlem, Neil Clark, who will be our next speaker.
And in that capacity, I've always believed that we needed to help the indigenous people and provide support and systems for them. I believe you have to agree that we are our brother's keepers and that we should help the needy and the poor, not the greedy. Thank you.